A very good morning to all of you, Rento bhaiya. So in the last class, we had discussed about the irrational number, and today I'm going to just continue that. Irrational number, as you know very well, that in the last class I had explained that any irrational number never be expressed in the form of p by q. It means if you talk about the irrational number, then they are not in the form of p by q. First thing, all of you just write down onto the copy. And second thing, all irrational numbers are non-terminating, non-repeating. Neither they are going to be terminate or neither they are going to be repeat. Okay, such type of numbers, real numbers, are known as the irrational number in mathematics. Okay, let's see an example. The square root of any non-perfect square numbers is always an irrational number. Not perfect square means perfect square like 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, they are the perfect square. And if we take the square root of 1, 4, 9, 16, 5, 25, then we get the rational number. But if there are some number which is square root, it means the they are not the perfect square, then in this condition, the square root always gives an irrational number. Okay to all of you? So that's why here under root 2, 2 is not a perfect square, that's why it is an irrational number. 1 by root 3, it is also an irrational number. 2 plus root 3, it is also an irrational number. But if anyone say that, what about under root 4? This one. So under root 4, here 4 is a perfect square. So we get from here 2. It's okay to all of you? So this is an rational number. So under root 4 is not an irrational number. This is not an irrational number. So always we keep in mind, after simplification, if we get the rational number, then in this condition, the given real number never be an irrational number. It's going to be rational number. Okay, always keep in mind. And there are some properties of the irrational number, and they are very important properties of the irrational number. You have to just write down it onto your copy, everyone. Properties of irrational number. When we talk about the properties of irrational number, students, then there are the first property, sum, difference, product and division. Chahe wo sum operation ho, chahe wo difference ka operation ho, chahe wo product ka operation ho, chahe wo division ka operation ho. It's sare operation to mathematical basic operation hai. Agar non-zero rational number, kaisa number? Non-zero rational number, this one. With irrational number. Non-zero rational number ka irrational number ke saath agar operation hota hai, sum ka, difference ka, product ka, division ka, to always we get an irrational number. Always ek irrational number milega. Theek hai? Let us see the example. Example of the first property. Let a rational number is equals to 2 and an irrational number is equals to under root 3. Now, if we talk about sum, then sum will be what we talk? 2 plus root 3. Irrational. This is an irrational number. And if we talk about difference, difference, again we get here 2 minus root 3, and this is also an irrational number. Irrational number. When we talk about the product of rational number with irrational number, it means 2 with root 3, then we get 2 root 3, also it is an irrational number, this one. When we talk about the division, everyone, division, in this case, we get the number like 2 by root 3, it's equals to an irrational number. This is going to be irrational number, this one. So when we talk about the operation, any basic operation with rational number and irrational number, then in this condition, always we get an irrational number. It is true. But condition is that rational number is always non-zero rational number. If a rational number is 0, 0 is also a rational number, then in this condition, we get the rational number. Except the condition of 0, all other condition mein jo bhi aapke operations hain, sabhi mein hame irrational number hi milega. In all cases, always. Is so good all of you? Good. Now, just see the property number 2. But sum and difference, product and division of irrational with irrational. When we talk about sum, difference, product with rational, इरेशनल एंड इरेशनल, यानी दोनों इरेशनल है। इन दिस कंडीशन में कोई जरूरी नहीं है कि मिलने वाला नंबर इरेशनल ही हो, इट मे बी पॉसिबल दैट इट विल बी रेशनल, सो दैट्स व्हाई वी कैन नॉट से एनीथिंग इन दिस कंडीशन। लेट अस सी द एग्जांपल फॉर द सेकंड प्रॉपर्टी, लेट अस सी द एग्जांपल फॉर द सेकंड प्रॉपर्टी एवरीवन। लेट्स से और इरेशनल नंबर, फर्स्ट इरेशनल नंबर, चूंकि अब दोनों रेशनल नंबर में लेने हैं, तो फर्स्ट इरेशनल नंबर इज इक्वल टू, मैंने लिख दिया रूट टू, एंड सेकेंड इरेशनल नंबर, इरेशनल नंबर मैंने लिख दिया माइनस अंडर रूट टू, दिस वन। नाउ जस्ट सी ऑन टू द बोर्ड, सम ऑफ बोथ, सम ऑफ बोथ वी गेट फ्रॉम हियर अंडर रूट टू माइनस अंडर रूट टू, गोइंग टू बी सम है, एक पॉजिटिव था एक नेगेटिव था, इसको ऐसे लिख सकते हैं अंडर रूट टू प्लस माइनस अंडर रूट टू, सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी व्हाट, जीरो। नाउ दिस इज रेशनल, ये रेशनल है यानी कि यह इरेशनल नहीं है, दिस वन इज नॉट एन इरेशनल नंबर, इट्स ओके ऑल ऑफ यू। जस्ट लाइक डिफरेंस, व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट डिफरेंस ऑफ अंडर रूट टू एंड it may be possible that under root 2, then this is equals to what? Under root 2 minus under root 2 going to be 0, again a rational number. When we talk about product, product of under root 2 and minus under root 2, then this is going to be minus under root 2 into under root 2. So we get from here minus 2, it is an irrational number, rational number. This one is a rational number. When we talk about the division, division in 2 root 2 by root 2, this one we get 2 root 2 upon root 2 going to be 2, again a rational number. So by this way we can say that when we talk about the basic operation sum, difference, product, division with rational and irrational, then in this condition it not be always in all condition we get an irrational number, it may be possible that we get the rational number also. Okay, there are some examples based on that. Okay, if we take the first number as root 2 minus root 2, then the sum of both going to be 0, which is a rational number, it means not an irrational number. Just like when we talk about difference of root 2 with root 2, we get the 0, again a rational number. When we talk about product of root 2 with minus root 2, then what you get? Minus root 2 into root 2, it means minus 2. This is an again rational number. Division in 2 root 2 by root 2, we get again 2, which is rational number. So, this means that I can say that in all cases, rational or irrational ka jo simple aapke paas operations hain, wo irrational nahi honge. It may be possible that ki wo rational bhi ho. Theek hai? So, that's why I have told you this. So, these are the two basic important properties of irrational number in mathematics. Always keep in mind that. Okay to all of you, so just write down it, and if you have any doubt you can ask everyone, if you have any doubt you can ask. Insertion of irrational number between two real number. Write on. Let the two positive real number are A and B. Then any one irrational number between both is equals to under root A into B. This one, under root A into B. Right on. Any one irrational number between both, which is under root A into B. Let us see an example, everyone. Let us see an example. Write any one
irrational number between 4 and 5. Between 4 and 5. This one. So here the solution will be 1 irrational number is equals to under root a into b, it means under root 4 into 5, it means under root 22, it means 2 root 5. This one is your answer, right? So by this way we can insert any irrational number between two given positive real numbers. This is the technique to insert the irrational number between the given real number. Okay everyone, let us see the one more example on it. Okay everyone, going to be explained. So here I am inserting the single irrational number between two given positive numbers. Now going to be insert any two irrational number between two given positive real number. So write down question, insert any two irrational number between 6 and 12. This one. So write down solution. First irrational number, let it is x is equals to under root a into b, and here a is equals to 6, b equals to 12, so we get under root 6 into 12. So we get from here 2 into 3 into 4 into 3, so we get from here 6 under root 2. This is the first irrational number x. Now second irrational number is equals to let this is y under root a into x. This one. So we get from here under root a is equals to 6 into 6 under root 2. This one. So we get from here 6 under root 2. This one. Right on. So this one is the second irrational number between these two given number 6 and 12. So by this way we can insert any number of irrational number between two given irrational number, students. I hope you all are enjoying this class, okay? And easily can solve such type of questions. Okay, everyone?